The Eyes of Penn, Episode 1. Written by Richard Carlton London. Narrated by Diarmid C. and Fiona H. Copyright 2023 Richard Carlton London. Prologue. This is the first episode of The Eyes of Penn, an audiobook series about the rock music band called The Johnsons. The Johnsons are a group of four musicians whose love for music and fellowship withstand the elusive goal of commercial success. They are tested by having to stand up to powerful forces outside of their influence that occasionally require the members of the band to tap into unique powers. This first episode, along with the second and final episode of The Eyes of Penn, was written, created, and produced for a listener that seeks an audiobook experience that is more supportive to listening challenges. Narrated like a friend reading to the listener at home, this audiobook is easy to follow. Each short chapter begins with a summary to help you track the story as it progresses. Music and sound files further provide enjoyable moments and spark imagination. And now we bring you the first episode audio of The Eyes of Penn.
Chapter 1, Meet Charts. In Chapter 1, we are introduced to Charts. She plays bass guitar for the Johnsons, a local rock band in Philadelphia. Have you ever heard of a female bass player? They are rare. In this chapter, Charts is on her way to practice with the band when she bumps into a stranger on a dark street. He demands that Charts request his permission to be allowed to walk on the street in this neighborhood. Let's listen in.
Walking along 19th and Washburn, Charts felt the dampness in her bones. The cold, dry air left a metallic taste in her mouth, and her breath cast small clouds of vapor in the evening darkness. She wrapped her arms around her chest to fight off the chill as she walked quickly down the street. The city seemed quieter than normal. Only the sounds of her boots hitting the sidewalk, bouncing across the abandoned lots and empty streets. The feeling of danger lurking everywhere in this neighborhood quickened her step. That, and the prospect of $20,000 for just one day of playing, that was any musician's dream job. Goosebumps on her arms prickled her skin. Scanning the houses she passed, they appeared like bunkers. Rows of small fortresses on a poorly lit street, darkened windows, heavy curtains, small ragged properties ringed with tall hedges. They all seemed to say, just move on, there's nothing here. She gripped a thick tree limb from a bush, dragging it in the tall hedges of tough leaves, as if she was just a kid on her way to the playground for some kickball with friends. But really, it was for security. Rounding the corner, she nearly collides with a man coming from the opposite direction, the limb slipping from her grasp, falling to the sidewalk with a dead clunk. Charts moves to one side in order to pass the man. The man blocks her way. "Excuse me," Charts says, moving aside to continue on to band rehearsal. The man blocks her again. She stops and looks at the man's face, trying to see some eyes under a dark hood. "What's up?" she asks. "What do you think is up?" the hoodlum says. "You're not going any further." "That's what's up." "Why not?" Charts asks. "Because this isn't your street." "This is my street. You're on my sidewalk. And you didn't ask my permission." With a quick glance up and down the immediate streets, Charts looked for any sign of life that could possibly save her from the predictable movie ending for a single woman, alone on a dark, empty street with a druggie.
Chapter 2. The Robber.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.